greetings and salutations. Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy, recording on the 1925 dictaphone, recording with the original speaking tube. Now, I just modified this with a connector on the end so I can use it on virtually any phonograph. I can use it on an Edison cylinder phonograph, I can use it on a Columbia cylinder phonograph, or I can use it on any dictaphone. So just recording with the original speaking tube, recording on a black wax phonograph cylinder. This is not a dictation cylinder. This is a blank for the Edison cylinder phonograph. I've got the machine running at 100 RPM, so I have approximately 4 minutes recording time on this cylinder. So recording with the original speaking tube, recording on the 1925 dictaphone, and recording on a black wax phonograph cylinder.
Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy with another in the series. Well, this is an MP3 transfer to the dictaphone. I want to do a direct comparison between an acoustic recording with a speaking tube and an MP3 transfer. So I'm recording this on my cell phone as a voicemail or a voice memo, and then I just email it to myself, open it on the iPad, and then use that audio file to do the transfer to the cylinder. So I'm actually recording this on the dictaphone. And so you have a direct comparison between an acoustic recording and an MP3 transfer recording. And as you can hear, there is a considerable amount of difference. Even though they're both straight acoustic recordings, technically, the MP3 transfer sounds much better, much more realistic, lifelike, and more like a recording on tape rather than a recording on a cylinder phonograph. So I just wanted to do a quick test transfer so you could actually hear the difference between an acoustic and a canaphonic recording. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com, and as always,